You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph. Happy Thursday, girls. It's Steph here.
Good morning, girls. It's Esther. And it's almost closer to the weekend, which makes everything always sweeter.
Esther, I have a question for you.
Uh-huh.
Would you pay me to spend time with you?
Pay you?
Yeah.
Like cash?
Yeah. Like $50, $100.
No. I wouldn't pay you a fool.
Okay, would you pay my mum to spend time with you?
No. Why would I have to spend, like, why would I have to pay someone to spend time with me?
Yeah, but you love us. Wouldn't you, like, pay?
Are you sure I love you? Well, just paying money sounds weird.
Yeah, it does.
Like, it sounds a bit dodgy.
Well, so, we asked this question to the girls.
Oh, actually. Yeah, that's right, we did.
So it's our microm girls. But before we get into that, would you pay money to spend time with your sister, your mother, your father, your best friend? Would you say, hey, you know, can you come over? I'll pay you. That is so weird.
That is so weird. All right, well, let's hear what the girls had to say about that.
Yes.
Okay, so today's question is, would you pay someone, a family member or a best friend or a friend, to spend time with you?
Well, I think it rather depends. If they're like, if they don't spend time with me enough, I'd probably pay them just to get them to hang out with me. But then again, if I do pay them, it doesn't really have that genuine feeling. Right? Because you're just paying them because they're doing it because you're paying.
Okay.
But if they, yeah. I wouldn't, because what's the point? Like, okay, if they're really like a genuine friend, or if they like genuinely love you, then they would like, they wouldn't want money to go hang out with you. And I don't really think that I would waste my money giving it to people just so they can spend time with me.
All right. Thank you, girls.
Interesting answers. Okay, so why are we talking about payment and spending time together? We do have a reason, and it's to do with our devotional, which I think is so sad.
I haven't read it, so I'd love to read it.
You can read it.
Can I Buy Some of Your Time? By Scott Higgins. A businessman who worked very long hours arrived home one evening to find his 7-year-old son waiting for him at the door. Daddy? Yeah, replied the man. Daddy, how much money do you make an hour? Well, son, I don't really think that's any business of yours, the man said. Please, Daddy, please tell me, how much do you make an hour? Pleaded the little boy. If I tell you, you promise you won't tell anyone else? I promise, said the little boy. All right then, said his father. I make $150 an hour. Oh, the little boy replied. He looked a little sad, then said, Daddy, may I borrow $20, please? His father was furious. If the only reason you wanted to know how much money I make is so you can borrow some, you can go straight off to bed. The little boy burst into tears and made his way to his room. After an hour or so, the father had come down and went to his son's room. I'm sorry for being so hard on you earlier, son. If you tell me what you wanted the $20 for, and it's a worthwhile thing, I'll think about giving it to you. The little boy ran across the room to his piggy bank and counted out all its content, exactly $130. $130, son, that's a lot of money. Surely that's enough for what you want to buy, said the father. Well, with the $20 you'll give me, it will be, the little boy replied. I'd like to buy an hour of your time.
Story.
Oh, can I just say I want to slap their father? Oh, I was so cranky at him.
Yeah, me too. I want to grab that little boy. I'm like, oh.
So he had $130 and he wanted $20 more to reach $150.
To pay his dad to spend time with him.
Oh, that is so depressing.
But it's so true though. Like, I think parents want to give so much to their kids that they don't spend time with their kids. especially at that age. But yes, it really is important to spend time with your family.
Mm. But we'll come back after this song.
This is the story of a runaway with no way home and no way out. I threw the best of me away. I had my chance, it's too late now. Too far gone and too ashamed to think that you'd still know my name. But love refused to let my story end that way. You didn't wait for me to find my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running after me when anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love moved first. Relentless grace would chase this rebel down. Crawl into this prisoner's cage. Take my hand and pull me out. You knew I couldn't make the change, so you became the change in me. And now I live to tell the story of the God who rescues. You didn't wait for me. Found my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running after me when anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love moved from the throne to the manger, from the manger to the grave. Your cross. Love made the first move. From a grave meant to keep you, to a stone rolled away. Your cross is the proof. Love made the first move. I remember where you found me. I'm amazed by where I stand. Your cross is the proof. The love made the first move.
Was Love Moved First by Casting Crowns.
So we actually have our question for today, which says,
I'm not allowed to have my bedroom door closed, but I don't get what the big deal is.
So this question will be answered by yours truly.
Yes,
Esther and me. So I think there's a concern that when you're not being watched, I think they're just really concerned that you're going to fall into something you shouldn't and then you won't be able to get out. So that's something like pornography.
And I think a closed door always indicates that, you know, that's your space. Nobody's allowed to come in. Nobody is to know what's behind that door. Like there's a lot of secrecy sometimes.
What are you hiding?
That's it. I think closing your door to get dressed. Yes, definitely.
Yeah, that's fine.
Or maybe if there are visitors at your house and you just want a bit of a quiet time, you know, sometimes your parents get visitors and you can't be there, then just go to your room and, you know, you can close your door. My suggestion to this question would be, first of all, you need to sit down with your parents and actually talk about why they are concerned. So there must be a reason behind it, like something that they want to protect you from. Like Steph was saying, there's too many temptations behind a closed door because no one is seeing what you're doing. You feel freedom to do whatever you want. And temptation will come knocking at your door. You don't have to find it. So I think first, talk to your parents. Second, you might get to compromise with maybe having your door only half closed, but with no technology and no laptop. The only thing you can have in your room at that time is either if you're coloring in, you're painting, you're drawing, or you're reading a book or something like that. So making sure that technology is never alone with you behind a closed door, because there's too many things that you will fall into temptation with. So yeah, that's all I would think, Stofa.
Yeah, and I think if there's nothing, you know, to hide, you shouldn't be ashamed of what you're watching or listening to, I guess. So that's another thing to think about.
Mm. So I hope this helped you. And girls, don't forget to send questions. Sometimes we will answer it. Other times we have pastors, chaplains, and psychologists who will answer your questions.
Well, thanks for the answers, Esther and Steph.
Oh, well, thank you for asking.
So, yes, that's it from us today, girls. We hope that you've enjoyed today's story and it's given you something to reflect upon.
Yes, I think that story, what we should apply is the way we are spending, the time we're spending with our family. I think sometimes when we sit around a couch, when we sit around the table, everybody brings out what?
Their telephone.
Their devices.
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't have time for your mom, for your dad, for your siblings. Everybody's in their own world. And this is what, sadly, what Satan, and I believe this 100%, that Satan has put in our lives where he wants us to be so busy on our devices that we have no connection with the people we are supposed to be connected to. And, you know, you have to love your parents and that. I remember when mom had a heart attack, It was scary because we didn't know how long we had her for. And if we don't spend those times with her, you know, what's going to happen later on?
Yeah.
So you need to be very conscious of what you do. You are teen girls. You are old enough to make the decisions to put it away. And if you need to tell your parents in a loving way to do that, you should.
Yeah, I think having a family meeting is important. Like, I understand when you do come back from work, your parents want some quiet downtime, and maybe you should schedule half an hour to an hour in the afternoons on your devices, but then turn it off for at least an hour or two and spend time together as a family.
Mm, yes. And even if you're doing homework and doing things, have the TV off, have technology away, just have some quiet breathing space, because technology suffocates.
Yeah, it does. Like, it gets noisy. It makes things noisy and exhausting. You can't think.
So that, and the other thing is spending time with God. He wants us to have time with Him, especially in the mornings. The first thing, instead of reaching for your phones, reach for your Bible, or if you do have a phone, reach for a Bible verse and start the day with God, inviting Him to be with you all day.
That's right. Remember, you can make time for it. You just got to choose to do that.
That's right.
So yeah, I think that's all from us.
Yes, that's it. Until tomorrow, which, what are we doing tomorrow?
Oh, let's have a look.
Oh, tomorrow we have a movie review.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it's Friday.
Yes.
In my mind, it's Wednesday. Never mind.
And we also have a great story.
Yes, tomorrow's one is called Harriet the Spy. Now, this one is one we have shared way, way, way long time ago, but it is so good, and I think it's something that we all might do.
It's good. You'll enjoy it. All right, girls, see you tomorrow, and let's pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for a new day you've given us. We ask that you open our hearts and minds that we can spend that amazing quality time with the people around us that love us, that we see the importance of being together and being connected, Lord. We ask you to be with us this day and in the things we need to face ahead. In your name, amen. This has been GIGI Radio signing out.